Please hold on and let me do very good questions today. Now, the equation of this curve is given, and of course this is 1/4 of a circle. He is asking the resultant force on AB and CD, and clearly it is given. See, every time the most important part is free surface, and he has given this as the free surface. This is the free surface. Chalo ek kaam karte hai. Let us take up CD first. I'll take up CD first. We'll try to so what is the question? He is asking the resultant force on CD and AB. Let's try to calculate the resultant force on CD and AB. Koi problem nahi hai. Okay, my dear students, listen now. Come back. We have already seen yesterday, in yesterday's class, if you want the horizontal component of force, you have to project the curve on the vertical plane, calculate the hydrostatic force on the vertical plane, corresponding vertical projection area. Ek kaam karo. Dekho ek baar. Let us take up this. Now. Okay. So when you project this curve, when you project this curve on the vertical plane, vertical plane, vertical plane, vertical plane, what do I get? Jab isko vertical plane project karenge, you will get a straight line. What is the length of this straight line? 0.3. But clearly the width is given. What is the width given? 2 meter. The width is given as 2 meter. Yes, my dear students. Now, we have to calculate the hydrostatic. So, if you want the horizontal component of force, horizontal is curve pay on 1/4 of a circle. If you want the horizontal component, you project it. We have already seen horizontal component of force on curved surface is equal to hydrostatic force on the vertical projection area. When you project that curve on the vertical plane, calculate the height. Already I had derived yesterday. So, you don't have to worry about that. Absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. Now let's proceed, my dear students. Let's proceed. Okay. Chalo. Now, let's try to find out the hydrostatic force. And you know, clearly you know this width is known to me. How much is this width given? This is given as 2 meter. And this length is already known. Already known. It is 0.3. It is 0.3. Very good. Now let's try to calculate the hydrostatic force on this. Let's try to calculate the hydrostatic force on this. Ispe, this area, on this area. Let's try to calculate on this area. Ek baar dekhte hai. Suno, my dear students. And you know, horizontal component of force on CD, this is equal to hydrostatic force is WAX bar. WAX bar. Now, let us see what is X bar. Already I told you many times, X bar is vertical distance of CG from the free surface. So, you know, this is the free surface. So, center of gravity kahan pe hoga? So, if this is, dekho, if this is 0.3, it's a plane uniform section. Agar ye 0.3 hai, to CG will be somewhere here. And this is 0.15. This total is, this total is 1 meter. And from the bottom, this total depth is 1 meter. Dekho, this total depth is 1 meter. So you remove this 0.15, because everything should be measured from free surface. So this total is 0.3. CG will lie here. So from the bottom, it is 0.15. From the total 1 meter, if you remove 0.15, it will be 0.85. This is 0.15. So this will be free. What is the meaning of X bar in this equation? Vertical distance of center of gravity. This is the vertical distance of center of gravity measured from the free surface. This is the free surface. So the total is 1. Remove this 0.15. This will be 0.85 meter. So therefore, now the horizontal component of force is equal to, for water, what is W? 9810. How? W is rho g. Rho for water is 1000. G is 9.81. 9.81 into 1000 is 9810. It is Newton per meter cube. So force will be Newton. Area. What is the area, my dear students? What is this area? The width is 2, height is 0.3. So therefore, 2 into 0.3 into x bar. What is x bar? What is x bar? 0.85 is the value of x bar. So you will get the horizontal component of force. Where is my calculator? Please get ready with calculators.
Yaar calculator kahan gaya? Kahan gaya re calculator? Kahan gaya?
Ek second, I'll bring my calculator.
Calculator आ गया.
9810 into 0.3 into 6 into 0.85. So I am getting this as 5003.1. Yes, Amit, you are right. Amit, you are right. But आपने unit नहीं दिया Amit. इसलिए मैं आपको गलत बोलूँगा. You have not given the unit, Amit. Roughly 5 kilo Newton ले लेंगे, 0, 0, 5 kilo Newton ले लेंगे. We'll take it as 5 kilo Newton, no problem. Now please stop. Let us try to calculate the vertical component of force. I repeat, we are dealing with CD. We are dealing with CD, my dear students. I am dealing with CD. ये देखो, I am dealing with CD. CD पे horizontal component is over. On CD the horizontal is over. Now I have to calculate vertical. No, Amit, you are wrong. 5000 kilonewton nahi hai, 5 kilonewton. Amit, again you are wrong. Again you are wrong, Amit Babu. Ab sahi hai. Very good. Units are very dangerous, my dear students. Units are very, very dangerous. Absolutely fine. Now, we'll go for the vertical component. Amit, sorry, bolo ek bar. Bolo beta. Haan. Now let us try to calculate the vertical component of force. Main bataya, vertical component of force. That is, haste is always dangerous. Especially, you know everything, but unfortunately, agar examination mein wo kilonewton mein puchta hai, to please be careful. Especially numerical ability questions are very, very important. Okay, I'm just kidding. I mean, enjoy the show. Right, up we want vertical component. How do I calculate vertical component of force? कल बोला था, vertical component of force, ये curve है, this is the curve. तो इस curve को कहाँ तक ले जाना है? Free surface. अब देख रहा, please, let us take this curve up to free surface, up to the free surface. देखो, ये curve है, यहाँ से up to the free surface. Okay, curve, देखो. Curve is starting from this position. Curve यहाँ से शुरू हुआ. तो ये please take it to the free surface. Ending here, take it to the free surface. और क्या करना है? I told you very clearly. Find the weight above the curve surface contained by this curve surface above this. Okay. Yes. Curve. इसके ऊपर का एरिया, फाइंड दिस एरिया अबाउट दिस, फाइंड द एरिया अबाउट दिस. ओके, नाउ आई मीन वॉल्यूम अबाउट दिस और वेट. सो अगर वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट ऑफ फोर्स चाहिए, यू कैलकुलेट द वेट ऑफ दिस, इस कर्व के ऊपर का वेट. ऑलरेडी आई हैड टोल्ड यू, सो डोंट वरी माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स नॉट वरी अबाउट दिस. कैलकुलेट द वेट ऑफ दिस. Calculate this weight. That will give me the vertical component of force. And what is the direction of vertical component of force? See, look at this top fluid will exert the force on our curved surface. On this curved surface, this is the curved surface. This top fluid will exert in the downward direction. This will be the vertical component. Vertical component is weight of this. Then how do I calculate weight? Ek bar suno idhar. How do I calculate weight? Please listen. What we do is, perpendicular to the plane of this screen, there is a width. Baad mein, first we'll calculate here. And you know, vertical component is equal to weight. Which weight? Whatever the weight I have shown. Now I'll tell you, which weight? Weight of the fluid. So I have to take density of fluid. My vertical component is weight of fluid. Which fluid? This shaded region fluid. Uska weight. Okay. We know that specific weight is weight by volume, or weight is equal to specific weight into volume, or weight is equal to specific weight is rho g into volume. Rho g into volume. So dekho, the vertical component is rho g. See, weight is always rho g volume, rho g volume, rho g volume, rho g volume. So kiska weight fluid ka? Rho of the fluid g into volume. Can I write volume as area into length? I can write volume as rho g. Volume can be written as area into length. First to calculate this area, then multiply with perpendicular to the plane of the screen, there is a width 2 meter diya, wo baad mein multiply karenge. First we'll calculate the area. Then how do I calculate the area? I'll calculate the complete rectangular area. What is that rectangular area? This radius is, dekho, this is 0.3. Are yaar, ye bhi radius hai na re baba. This is the radius. So I can calculate this area. What is this area? This is 0.3 and this is 1. This is 1 and this is 0.3. So I can calculate the complete area. From that area, you remove this 1/4 of a circle. So you will get this area. So if I multiply that area with width 2, you get the volume. Chalo, let's do that exercise. Dekho ek baar. So vertical component is equal to rho of the fluid. It is 1000. G is very good. Very good. Very good, Aditya. Into G is 9.81 area. Which area? Dekho, first you calculate complete rectangular area. This length is 1 and it is 0.3. So 1 into 0.3, that is the complete rectangular area, minus pi, radius of the circle is 0.3. But this pi r square is the area of circle. But I don't have complete circle. I have 1/4 of a circle. So divide with 4. Pi r radius is 0.3. Pi r square is area of circle. But you have to remove only 1/4 quarter of a circle. Removed. And this is the area which we want. Into width is 2. So if you calculate, can you give me vertical component ka value? Make it fast. Amit, kitna aa raha hai? Amit, 4.7. Is it 4 points? No one is giving. Only Amit has given. What is happening, my dear students? If you don't calculate, you will die. I am getting 4.5. This will be 4000. Amit, again you have done, you have committed a mistake. It is 4.5 kilo newton. Kya ho raha hai sir? Aap log na answer hi nahi de rahe. Very sorry. Anavalesh, 1.125 baad mein. Sir, means simple calculation also you are not in a position to do. Then how can I expect from you? Ye galat hai. Means you, online classes ka matlab kya hai? Ghar pe baith ke jo bhi teacher kar raha hai, wo and you have to do it. Otherwise, I leave everything. When I am taking calculator and doing, and you people are sitting. Yes, 4, and everyone should do it. And now what I do is, beech mein, I'll ask whether you have calculated or not, whether you are writing or not, aapko screenshot bhejna padega. 4.4 is wrong. Rajesh. Now, see my dear students. Second time is sahi hua. Matlab first time gate mein likho to second time karenge, utna time rahega. And you people are not calculating. I am not at all happy with you. This is very sorry state I am telling you, and sad state. यू पीपल आर थिंकिंग दैट वी कैन डू इट इन एग्जामिनेशन, मतलब नेट प्रैक्टिस, बिना नेट प्रैक्टिस के ग्राउंड में जाके खेलेंगे आप? अरे व्हेन देयर इज नो सफिशिएंट प्रैक्टिस यू कैन नॉट डू इट, आई एम टेलिंग यू. ट्रीट एवरी क्वेश्चन एज इफ यू आर सिटिंग इन एग्जामिनेशन हॉल. प्लीज आई एम नॉट हैप्पी विथ यू पीपल because when your teacher is struggling for your cause, you are just casually taking things casually. Amit, utna difference to nahi aayega na beta. Aap diye the 4.7 diye the. 4.7 aa raha hai? Utna difference to nahi aayega na? Now, let's take this curved surface. Dekho ek baar. This is the curved surface. Yes, this is D and this is C. And dekho ek baar, how is the fluid exerting? Everywhere it is normal, normal, it is normal. Means you have seen horizontal component is to the right. So the horizontal component, dekho, just I repeat, dekho ek baar, dekho. This is the curved surface. How is the fluid exerting? It is normal. It's like this, normal, I say exert kar raha hai. So, देखो, the force is normal to this, normal to this, normal to this. So, the force is normal because it is hydrostatic pressure force. Pressure is always normal, normal. Is surface को normal. See the horizontal component. It is to the right. See the vertical component. It is down. Let this be the resultant force and let this be the angle made by the resultant with horizontal. So, already you know the horizontal. Now you know the vertical. Now you know the vertical. Yes, my dear students. So the resultant is equal to under root of fh square plus fv square. Correct? So therefore, let us calculate the resultant force on the curved surface CD. Resultant force on this curved surface CD, 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 CD. 1 second, please. సార్ పర్లే నేను అదే క్లాస్కి వెళ్ళే ముందు ఒకసారి చేసిండే, ఏం లేదు సార్, వాళ్ళు వస్తే చెత్తుళ్ళు వస్తే మీరు కూడా వెళ్ళండి అని, మీరు కూడా మాట్లాడండి అని. మీరు వెళ్ళండి సార్, మీరు వెళ్ళండి. ఓకే ఓకే సార్, నేను క్లాస్లో ఉన్నాను సార్. ఓకే రైట్ ఓకే 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 రైట్ దేఖో నౌ అండర్ రూట్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫ్హెచ్ స్క్వేర్ దట్ ఈస్ 5 స్క్వేర్, ఎఫ్వి స్క్వేర్ వర్టికల్ 4.5 స్క్వేర్. अभी तो सही आंसर दे देना. नाउ एटलीस्ट यू गिव द राइट आंसर. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ रिजल्टेंट? एफ एफ एनीवन? एफ
ये भी नया तो देखो नमूने है पूरे. 25 प्लस 4.5
कितना आ रहा? 6.72 ना? यस 6.72. ऑफ कोर्स किलो न्यूटन, ऑफ कोर्स किलो न्यूटन, ऑफ कोर्स किलो न्यूटन. एब्सोल्युटली फाइन. But now I want the angle. Can you tell me the angle? Tan theta is equal to, either dekho, please listen. Tan theta. What is tan theta? Please understand carefully. Bolo re, let's cut this. This FH I write here. So this is the resultant. Okay, very good, very good. Now, let it be theta. तो क्या होगा? This is your vertical ना? This is vertical and this is horizontal. So what is tan theta with horizontal? Tan theta कितना आ रहा है? हाँ. Okay, good. Tan theta will be FV by tan theta A. Tan theta is FV opposite by adjacent, that is FH. He's asking with horizontal. So therefore, tan theta will be equal to what is vertical? Vertical kitna hai? What is vertical? 4.5. And the horizontal is 5. So you are getting theta as tan inverse. Kitna ra hai? Anyone with this 4.5 by 5 is equal to 41.98, na? 41.98. Absolutely fine. It is with horizontal. Please tell me, is the question clear? All of it, is the question clear? इज इट क्लियर माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स? एब्सोल्युटली, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. अब आगे बढ़ते हैं. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, होल्ड ऑन, सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाट इज द फोर्स ऑन ए बी? वेरी गुड. ही इज आस्क्ड बिकॉज इट इज अ कॉमनली यूज्ड शेप, सो वी नो एरिया ऑफ सर्कल, दैट्स व्हाई वी कुड कैलकुलेट दिस वेरी इजीली. बट दिस इज नॉट कॉमनली यूज्ड शेप, एंड हाउ आर वी गोइंग टू टैकल दिस, लेट मी एक्सप्लेन. चलो, let's try to find out the force on AB. This AB, AB, AB. Already we have calculated CD, so there is no problem. Let's try to find out the force on AB. Okay. हाँ, तो एक काम करते हैं, यहीं पे रख देंगे. ये itself it will be better. Okay. So I'll remove this. I'll remove this. So no problem. I'll remove this. Yeah. Now we'll try to find out the, is it clear, my dear students, all of you? Is the question clear? So let's move to the second part. Yes. Chalo. वेरी सिंपल. अब एक काम करते हैं, विल रिमूव दिस पार्ट ऑल्सो. ऑलरेडी वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड दिस ना, विल रिमूव दिस पार्ट ऑल्सो. ओके, विल यूज मैक्सिमम स्पेस. राइट, नाउ आई वॉन्ट द फोर्स ऑन एबी. Now I want the force on AB, AB, AB. Let's try to calculate the force on AB. So, ये कर्व को कहां प्रोजेक्ट करना है बोलो एक बार. इस कर्व को, if you want the vertical component, if you want the horizontal component, where are we supposed to project this curve? On the vertical plane. Vertical plane. Let's project it. Okay. So now this is the vertical projection. Yeah, this is the vertical projection. And you know, my dear students, perpendicular to the plane of this screen, there is a width. And this length is 1. Perpendicular to the plane of the screen, there is a width. And I am not showing to the scale. ये होगा आपका, yes. Okay, no problem at all. No problem whatsoever. चलो, right. Let's try to calculate. Vertical projection of parallelogram is yeah. If, why if, you have to take it. So therefore, what is this length? ये length कितना है? 1 meter. This length. And what is the width? This width is 2 meter. ये width 2 meter है. ये width 2 meter है. Okay. Now, let us calculate the horizontal component of force is equal to hydrostatic force on the vertical projection area. Is curve ko vertical plane pe project karna, and you calculate the hydrostatic force on this. Okay, let's try to calculate the hydrostatic force on this. On this. Iske upar calculate karke, this area. Yes, my dear students, let's calculate on this. Ho gaya. चलो, now F is equal to horizontal component hydrostatic force W A X bar. W is 9810 because it is water rho g. Area, what is the area? The width is 2, height is 1, so therefore it is 2 into 1. Can you tell me X bar? This is the free surface. So where is the center of gravity? Where is the center of gravity? देखो एक बार, this is the center of gravity. if the total height is 1 meter, 1 meter from the free surface, where is the center of gravity? It is 0.5. That is x bar. It is 0.5 and therefore it is 0.5. So can you give me the horizontal component of force? Anyone? Horizontal component of force kitna raha hai? I think it is 9.81 kilonewton. This is Newton. I think it is 9.81 kilonewton. Is it clear, my dear students? I mean, is it clear? Now we'll go for the vertical component of force. Now we'll go for, so horizontal to aa gaya. And can you tell me the direction of horizontal force? Because this side you have fluid. Actually, the fluid will exert normal to the surface, normal to the surface. So the horizontal component will be to the right, to the left. Okay, 9.81. Up, we'll calculate the vertical component of force. This is very important. So let's try to calculate the vertical component of force. Idhar dekho. Right. Now, right. And this is y is equal to x square. Okay. Now, how do I calculate vertical component of force? Very simple. Take the curve, okay. Go up to free surface. This is the free surface. Go up to free surface. Curve up to free surface. So calculate the weight of this curve up to free surface. Yes. Then how can I calculate the volume of this? You know how. So how do I calculate vertical component of force? Curve up to free surface. Curve le lena, go to the free surface. Calculate the weight of the fluid. And you know that the vertical component is equal to weight. And always I told you weight is rho g into volume. Which weight? Fluid weight. So this should be density of fluid, which is 1000. Volume. Which volume? Shaded volume. And perpendicular to the plane of the screen, there is a width, which is 2 meter. And yeah, first I'll calculate the area. If I multiply this area with 2, I'll get the volume. But now how to calculate? Now, please observe. How do I calculate? Ab dekhna. How do I calculate? Very simple, my dear students. Simple mathematics. Simple mathematics. You are getting 13 point something resultant. Achha, you are getting vertical. Vertical, excellent. 13 is the right answer, Navilesh. Very good. So, kuch mat karna. Let this be y. Y, and you know this is x. Ye x hai. Aur ye dy hai. So first I'll calculate the area of this small strip. And if I want the total area, I'll integrate from 0 to 1. Because this is, y is varying from 0 to 1. Okay, no problem at all. Please look at my dear friends. Can you tell me the area of simple mathematics? Calculus, simple mathematics. What is the area of this small strip? Small strip area is equal to x into dy. This small area is x into dy, x into dy. Agar aapko total area chahiye, you integrate this from where? 0 to y is varying from 0 to 1. But you know that y is equal to x square. So x is equal to under root of y. So area will be equal to under root of x. X is root y dy. And it is varying from 0 to 1. So isko integrate karna. So area will be equal to what is y power 1 by x power n is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So y power 1 by 2 is y power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 1 by 2 plus 1. And it is varying from 0 to 1. It is varying from 0 to 1. So area will be equal to, so this is 1 plus 2 is 3 by 2, means it is 2 by 3 into y power 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2. And it is 0 to 1. So you are getting this area as 2 by 3 into 1 power 3 by 2 minus 1. So area is equal to 2 by 3. Area 2 by 3. So what will be the volume? Volume is equal to area into width. Perpendicular to the plane of the screen, there is a width. So kitna aa raha hai? 2 by 3 into width is 2. So width is 2. This width is given as 2, 2, 2. So therefore, it will be 4 by 3 meter cube. So therefore, vertical component is rho. Water rho is 1000 and g is 9.81. And volume of the fluid is 4 by 3. So I think you are getting this as 9.81 by 3, 13.08. So 13.08 into 10 power 3 newton or 13.08 kilonewton. Please tell me, are we clear? I think you are getting this as 13.03. Is it clear? Clear, my dear students? Yes, absolutely. Very good. Now we'll see. Have a look at this. Now we'll try to. Horizontal is known. How much is horizontal? Horizontal we have already calculated. How much is horizontal? 9.81. And vertical is 13.08. So let's try to find out. Dekho ek baar. This is the curved surface. And we have, this is the free surface. We have fluid on this side. Ab dekho, see, it will exert normal force. Dekho ek baar, this is the fluid, it will exert normal force. So definitely, if the fluid is exerting like this, so the horizontal will be to the left, vertical will be upward. Okay, so now the horizontal is calculated, that is 9.81, and the vertical is calculated, that is how much? Vertical kitna hai? 13.08. Of course, all are in kilonewton. Let this be FV and let this be FH. Okay, now this is the resultant F. Let it make an angle theta. Let this be F. Okay, now. Is it okay, my dear students? Okay, no problem at all. So therefore, F will be equal to under root of FH square plus FV square. So resultant F is equal to root FH square, 9.81 square plus vertical is 13.08 square. So resultant force is equal to, kitna aa raha hai? Anyone, what is the resultant force? 16.35 kilonewton. Very good. And tan theta will be equal to, what is tan theta? Dekho, tan theta, ye to vertical hai, ye horizontal, FV by FH. Therefore, tan theta is equal to vertical. Vertical is 13.08 and the horizontal is 9.81. So you get the value of theta. Anyone, what is theta? Anyone? 52.96, na? Let me check. Okay. Chalo, that is the right answer. Hope the question is clear. Please tell me, is the question clear, my dear students? Is the question clear? Now we'll take one more wonderful question. Yeah, 53 point something, na? Yeah, I'm getting 53. Correct. 53, yeah, 53 point something is correct. Chalo, aage bade. Shall we proceed, my dear students? Bolo, bolo, bolo. Bolo, bolo. Shall we proceed with your permission? ऑफ कर देंगे. वेरी गुड, गॉट इट ना आदित्य? वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. नाउ विल डू सम मोर लवली क्वेश्चंस सो दैट यू विल गेट ब्यूटीफुल कॉन्सेप्ट्स. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज, सी प्लीज होल्ड ऑन प्लीज, पेशेंस बहुत जरूरी है, पेशेंस बहुत जरूरी है. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डू वन ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन सो दैट यू विल गेट अ क्रिस्टल क्लियर आइडिया. ऑल ऑफ यू देखो, नाउ देयर इज अ टैंक. Let's do one good question. अरे यार, ये भी नमूना है आपकी तरह. Yeah. Now there is this is 1/4 of a circle. This is 1/4 of a circle. ये वाला 1/4 है. Again a good question, my dear students. Okay, good. सही नहीं आ रहा फिगर. Okay, good. This is also a good question. Yes. Again, this is 1/4 of a circle. एक सेकेंड, फिगर मुझे सही नहीं बैठ रहा है, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं. And there is a pressure gauge here. This is a, now free surface नहीं दिया इस प्रॉब्लम में. The pressure given is 19.62 into 10 power 3 newton per meter square. Okay, this is water. This is completely water. Completely water. Okay, na? Yeah, up sahi hai, dekho. Right. See the beauty of this question. Please all of you listen. There is a curved surface. Again, this is given as 1/4 of a circle. This is 1 meter. Now, this is all water. अब सवाल ये है, the magnitude and direction of the resultant force on, this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, and this is E. He is asking magnitude and direction of the resultant force on CB, BC, BC. That is the question. Dekho, the mag, dekho, I want on BC, I want on BC, BC, BC. Okay, no problem at all. This is all water. Please look at, my dear students. Yeah, this is completely water. Right, ye water hai. Now what is, wait, what is he asking? He is asking the force on the resultant force on the curved surface AB. Stop, my dear students. Whenever the free, is the free surface given? No. Yaha ka pressure, what is the pressure here? What is the pressure here? 19.62. Here the pressure is 19.62. So what we do is, first we'll calculate what does 19.62 pressure in terms of height correspond to. We have studied long back in pressure measurement, P is equal to rho gh, and I told very clearly this is a gauge pressure. Whenever I write P is equal to rho gh, it is a gauge pressure, and I have derived very clearly. So ek kaam karte hai, h is equal to P by rho g. Already this is the pressure gauge, so this is indicating gauge pressure only, so this equation is correct. So what is the pressure? 19.62 into 10 power 3 by rho, it is 1000, and g is 9.81. so therefore h will be equal to 2 meter. It means, so if you, it means if you want a pressure of 19.62 here, there has to be this water, because this 1000 is water. There should be water for a height of 2 meter. Matlab free surface yaha se is depth, there will be free surface from here above, it is 2 meter water. Then only if the water is, if there is water up to 2 meter, yaha the height of 2 meter, so then the pressure will be 19.62 here. So therefore free surface will be somewhere at 2 meters. So now let us try to do this clearly. Dekho, see the question clearly. Now it's something like this. So free surface is very, very important. So actually you have idhar le lenge. Okay, from here up to a height of 2 meter, this is the free surface. This is a free surface. Okay, na? Very good. Now, width is also given. Width is given 2 meter. Ek second. 2 meter. 2 meter. 2 meter. Width is 2 meter. Perpendicular plane of the screen, the width is given as 2 meter. This width is 2 meter. Now, how do we do this? Hope you yahan tak clear hua, yahan tak clear hua. So free surface is very, very important. Now let us calculate the horizontal component of force. Let's calculate the horizontal component of force, my dear students. Idhar dekhna, whenever you want horizontal component of force, you have to project it on the vertical plane. Is curve ko vertical plane project karna, and look at, so if the radius, dekho yahan se the radius is 1 meter, so definitely this will be 1 meter, because radius is 1 meter. So this will be 1 meter. And what is the width? What is the width? 2 meter. Width is 2 meter. Okay, this is 1 meter. The width is 2 meter. So let us calculate the horizontal component of force. One more thing, this is the free surface. This is the free surface. Now, where will be the center of gravity? Where will be the center of gravity? Agar ye 1 meter hai, to center of gravity will be 0.5. 0.5. Aur ye height hai 2 meter. Can you tell me what is the meaning of x bar? This is x bar. Free surface say. From the free surface, this is the center of gravity. Center of gravity. So it is 2, it is 0.5. So x bar is 2.5. X bar is 2.5. X bar is 2.5. X bar is 2.5. This is x bar is 2.5. Dekho, ye 0.5 hai, ye 2 meter hai. Ye 2 meter, ye 0.5 hai. From the free surface, it is 2.5. So the horizontal component of force is equal to WAX bar. So please, all of you, are you getting? So always from the free surface, always from the free surface. So therefore, W is 9810. Area. What is the area of this? What is the area of this? Width is 2, height is 1. So area is 2 into 1 and x bar is 2.5. So the horizontal component of force is equal to 9.81 into 5. 49.05. Actually, this will be Newton divided with 1000. It will be in kilonewton. 49.05. Please tell me, is it clear? Is it clear, my dear students? Is it clear, all of you? Yes, 49.05 is the right answer. Now, let's try to calculate the vertical component of force. Vertical component of force. Okay. Right. How do I calculate vertical component of force? Dekho, curve yahan pe shuru hua. Aur yahan khatam hua. To curve kahan tak le jana hai? Free surface. कर्व कहां तक ले जाना है? फ्री सरफेस. यस, अप टू द फ्री सरफेस. यस, तो कर्व अप टू फ्री सरफेस. सो देयरफॉर लेट अस कैलकुलेट ये कर्व अप टू फ्री सर्विस कर्व एंड परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ दिस देयर इज अ विड्थ. ओके, यस, वेरी गुड. अब हाउ डू आई कैलकुलेट? देखो एक बार, वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट इज वेट. वेट इज इक्वल टू रो जी इनटू वॉल्यूम. तो वे वॉल्यूम, कैन यू टेल मी हाउ टू कैलकुलेट वॉल्यूम? Volume is always equal to area into length. Volume is always equal to area into length. इधर देखना. I will calculate this area. What is the width? Okay, ये कितना है? This is the radius. So this is the radius. So if this is the radius, देखो एक बार. If this is the radius of 1 meter, what will be the horizontal? अरे यार, ये horizontal, ये 1 meter. This is the radius. Radius is 1 meter. If the radius is 1 meter, देखो एक बार. If the radius is 1 meter. Definitely this horizontal will also be 1 meter. Okay, so therefore vertical component is equal to rho is 1000, g is 9.81 volume. What is the volume area? So kya calculate karke, you calculate this area first, 2 into 1 plus 1/4 of a circle area into width 2 meter diya hai. So let's calculate area. First we'll calculate the rectangular area. This height is 2, this is 1, therefore 2 into 1, okay na, plus 1/4 of a circle, pi radius is 1, but it is circle, 1/4 of circle, into width. What is that width? That is 2. Can anyone give me the vertical component of force? Anyone, vertical component of force? 54.64. very good. 50, this will be in Newton, divide with 1000, you'll get it in kilonewton. Very good, my dear students, we got the vertical component of force. Horizontal is known, vertical is known. Now let us calculate the resultant. No issues at all. Dekho ek baar, how do you expect the force to be acting on this? Because there is a fluid here, there is a fluid that will exert normal to the surface. So now I write this as this is the force. So the horizontal is FH, the vertical is FV, and this is your resultant F. Let this angle be theta. So therefore the resultant force is given by under root of FH square plus FV square. So therefore horizontal component is equal to, so the horizontal kitna hai, 49.05 ka square plus vertical. What is vertical? 54.64. Anyone, what is the resultant? Why 2 meter is taken above AB? Above AB. Where is A? Hare yaar, what is the pressure here? If you see the pressure, why 2 meter? Where is the free surface? It is pressurized tank. When I derive the equation, because minimum two is required. Hare yaar, how can I get the pressure of 19.62 if there is a liquid of 2 meter here? Means, can you tell me what is the pressure here? Are you finding the difference between this and this x second? Let me complete this. What is the resultant? I'm coming to it. What is the resultant? Anyone? 73.42. Very good. Let me complete this and I'll come to Aditya. And tan theta. What is tan theta? Anyone? What is tan theta? F vertical. So this is resultant, this is horizontal, and this is vertical. This is vertical, this is horizontal. So tan theta will be equal to, what is tan theta? FV by FH. So therefore vertical is kitna hai? Vertical kitna hai? 54.64. And the horizontal is 49.05. And therefore theta will be equal to, anyone, theta kitna aa raha hai? 48.1 degree. Very good. Stop. He says, why are you taking 2 meter above? Now tell me, for example, dekho ek baar, this is the free surface. I want the force on this. So if this is the free surface, up to where are you supposed to go? So this is the free surface. So what is the pressure here? The pressure here is only due to this column. But if the pressure is not atmospheric here, if it is 19.62, means there will be this much column that will exert force on this. So is the pressure here not, if it is 19.62 here, is it not because of this column also the pressure is exerted here? That's why I have taken the total, because there is a difference between free surface here and there is a difference between, listen carefully, there is a difference between free surface here and free surface somewhere. In this case, if the free surface is above 2 meter, the force on this will be large. If the curved surface is like this and if the free surface is here, the force on this will be less, because this much height of the column is exerting on this, because it's not atmospheric. Here it is atmospheric, but here it is not atmospheric. Here it is more than atmospheric, 19.62. To get 19.62, I need 2 meter column. Complete that 2 meter column is exerting on this. Is it clear? Now clear. Is the question clear, my dear students? All of you, is the question clear? You are not saying anything. Is it clear? Is the question clear? Bolo. If it is clear, I'll proceed. Bolo. Excellent, my dear students. Now we'll take up one more beautiful question. The question is this. Ye bahut hi acha hai. So let us become strong in curved surfaces. Okay, very good. Chalo. Yes. Now a good question. Now a very, very good question. Dekhiye. Wow. This is a wonderful question, my dear students. Density of fluid is 700 here. And the density of this fluid is 800. Of course, kilogram per meter cube. Yes. See, the question is, a cylinder 1 meter diameter, iska diameter hai. See the diameter. The diameter of this is 1 meter. Okay. And the length perpendicular to the plane of the screen, length is 2 meter. Okay now? Yes. Now, it is in equilibrium as I have. What is the density of the cylinder? Please look at carefully. There are two different fluids here. This is one fluid and this is another fluid. There are two different fluids. यस एक देखो देर इज अ सिलेंडर देर इज अ सिलेंडर लुक एट केयरफुली देर इज अ सिलेंडर इट्स डायमीटर इज 1 meter परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ द स्क्रीन द लेंथ इज 2 meter आई थिंक
एक सेकंड
या द लेंथ और द लेंथ ऑफ द सिलेंडर इज 2 meter देर इज ऑयल एट द स्टॉप देर इज वॉटर सॉरी अनदर फ्लूइड अनदर ऑयल ओके नाउ ही इज आस्किंग दिस इज द सेंटर ओके एक सेकंड दिस इज अ ब्यूटिफुल क्वेश्चन दिस इज द सेंटर सेंटर राइट सही है ना हा दिस सेंटर नाउ ऑफकोर्स दिस लेंथ विल बी The diameter is 1 meter. This is the radius. So, this will be 0.5 meter. Are you total diameter? Yeah, this diameter is 1 meter. So, this is 0.5 meter. Now, he is asking, what is the density of the cylinder? Let's try to do it in a beautiful manner. Let's try to do it in a very beautiful manner. Kuch mat karna suno pehle. See, what I try to do is, He is asking density of the cylinder, which is staying in equilibrium. When it is in equilibrium, means the vertical upward force is balanced with the downward force. Let us take vertical equilibrium from where I can easily calculate the density. Yeah, this is open to atmosphere. This is open to atmosphere. This is open to atmosphere. Right side, ये पूरा atmosphere है. Right side, ये पूरा atmosphere है. Yeah. See, it's very clear from the figure. There is fluid on this side. It's very clear. There is fluid on this side. There is fluid here. There is no fluid here. And this is open to atmosphere. Okay. Now, please understand carefully. So, let me take up vertical equilibrium. Let me take up vertical equilibrium, vertical equilibrium, vertical equilibrium. Let's take up vertical equilibrium. Okay. Now, if you observe carefully, this portion this okay isko divide karenge hum a b or d let us divide this into these part a b c and d if you see the portion ab this portion ab is just exposed to this yellow fluid of density 700. I repeat my difference. This portion AB is exposed to only this fluid. But what about portion BC? You may be thinking, sir, BC is exposed only to this fluid. It's wrong. Can you tell me, I'll ask you a simple question. There is fluid 1, there is fluid 2. What will be the pressure here? Though this point is in second fluid, the pressure at this point is due to this column plus this column. Means at this point, the pressure is influenced not only by this fluid, but also this fluid. But if you take any point here, it is influenced only by this fluid. Means AB portion is exposed only to this fluid. So therefore, on AB, the force will be only due to this fluid. But on BC, can you tell me what is the pressure here? If you want pressure somewhere here, it is because of this fluid and this fluid. Means on BC, there is an influence of this fluid and this fluid. All of you are be clear? All of you are be clear? Understand carefully. Means BC pain. इसका भी इंफ्लुएंस है और इसका भी इंफ्लुएंस है एब्सोल्युटली नो प्रॉब्लम व्हाटसोएवर सो लेट्स ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड केयरफुली मैं क्या करूंगा यहां पे सुनो ध्यान से Let me take some water, please. Okay, please listen. देखो एक बार, A B A B A B. I'll calculate the force on AB. How do I calculate the force on AB? चिंता मत करना. AD is not exposed to any fluid, so leave AD. My BD is exposed to this fluid, but the force on BD is influenced by this also, because if you calculate the pressure here is due to this column plus this column. So BD, let's calculate separately. AB, let's calculate separately. And total vertical component of force should balance with the, I'll do very simply, in a simple manner. Can you tell me the direction of the force, vertical component of force on AB? If you observe clearly, this fluid is exerting like this. This fluid, Yewala fluid, normal. So if you see the direction of vertical component of force, my dear students, this fluid, this is exerting like this, like this, like this. So if you see the direction of vertical component, it is downward. So on the portion AB, the vertical component of force is downward. Weight of the cylinder is downward. So total downward should be equal to total upward. Now tell me, on the portion BD, what will be the direction of force? This fluid, ek bar dekhna, this fluid will exert like this. This fluid will exert like this. If you see the vertical component, it is upward. So on lower portion, on the lower portion BD, the vertical component is upward. On the lower portion BD, the vertical component is upward. The fluid is exerting in upward direction. On AB, it is on AB, the vertical component is downward. Weight of the cylinder downward. So what I do is total downward force should be equal to total upward force. On AB, the force is downward. Who is exerting fluid? Fluid. So downward. Weight of the cylinder is downward. So downward, total downward is upward. So weight of the cylinder plus the vertical component of force on AB, both downward, should be equal to the vertical component of force on BD. Then when both are equal, then I can easily calculate the density. Ab dhyan se suno. Let me try to calculate weight of the cylinder. Weight of cylinder. What is weight of the cylinder? Dekho ek baar. Weight is always rho g volume. Rho g volume. So therefore, rho of the cylinder g into volume of the cylinder. So can you tell me what is volume of the cylinder? Idhar dekhna. Is equal to, sorry, weight of the cylinder. Weight of the cylinder, which is in downward direction. I don't know rho of the cylinder because he is asking us to calculate that only. G, what is volume of the cylinder? Pi by 4 d square. Diameter of the cylinder is how much? Dia of the cylinder is 1. Pi by 4 d square. And the length, pi by 4 d square, L is the volume. So volume is pi by 4 d square. Length is given as 2. So I got the weight of the cylinder. I got weight of the cylinder. Let it be 1. No problem. Which is in downward direction. Now let us try to calculate the vertical component of force on AB. Chalo, this is the free surface. 1 second. So let's try to calculate the vertical component of force on AB. Dekho. This is A and this is B. And you know this is the radius. What is the radius? Diameter is 1. So radius is 0.5 meter. Yes. Okay. Now, how do I proceed? Take the curve. Ye to free surface hai. What is the density of this fluid? 700. So the vertical is pe vertical component. Dekho, this is the fluid. This fluid will exert like this. The vertical component will be downward. Downward. So how do I do this? Take this curve up to free surface. Take the curve up to free surface. एंड इस कर्व के ऊपर का एरिया कैलकुलेट करना. यस, नाउ ऑब्जर्व क्लियरली. सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट दिस. व्हाट इज द डेंसिटी? ओके 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 यस. एंड इफ यू कैलकुलेट द वेट ऑफ दिस, आई रिपीट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू कैलकुलेट द वेट ऑफ दिस वर्टिकल कॉम्पोनेंट इज ऑलवेज वेट. Vertical component is always wait. Yes, अब देखना. Please wait. No comments. तो curve के ऊपर का weight. So therefore, now I write, my dear students, the vertical component is weight of fluid. Fluid. That will be rho of the fluid g into volume. देखो. Which volume? Shaded volume. This shaded volume. Then how do I calculate shaded volume? And it is the radius. If it is a radius, this will also be 0.5. This will also be 0.5. So therefore, now volume calculate karenge. What will be the volume? Anyone, what will be the volume? First calculate the total area. This is 0.5. This is 0.5. So total area se aap isko nikal dena. 1/4 of a circle, you will get the shaded region. टोटल एरिया से 0.5 टोटल एरिया से 0.5 टोटल एरिया से ये 1/4 सर्कल निकाल देना हो गया. तो क्या होगा? इट इज 0.5 इंटू 0.5. ओके, माइनस पाई. रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल इज 0.5 पाई आर स्क्वायर, बट दिस इज फॉर कंप्लीट सर्कल, बट इट इज 1/4 ऑफ द सर्कल, बट दिस इज ओनली एरिया. एरिया there is a length perpendicular to the plane, there is a length. Kitna length hai? 2 meter. So multiply with 2, so you will get the volume. So therefore, can you tell me what is the vertical component? Dekho, vertical component is equal to, can you tell me which fluid is this? This ye fluid ka density kitna hai? Which fluid is exiting of density 700? So iska density, its density is 700. So therefore, it is 700 into g is 9.81. So vertical component is rho g volume into this volume, into this volume. So can you tell me what is the value? Anyone? No one is giving. Very sorry. Give me the value. I will not tolerate answer. अरे आप, मैं बोल रहा हूं कैलकुलेट करो ना. 736. ओके, न्यूटन और किलो न्यूटन. अगेन अमित, आप बहुत मिस्टेक कर रहे बेटा. अरे यार, आप लोग कैलकुलेशन भी नहीं आ रहा. समवन से 75. दिस इज वेरी, आई एम वेरी सॉरी टू से दैट योर कैलकुलेशन पार्ट इज वेरी नॉट बैड, वर्स्ट. अरे ऐसा है तो कैसा सिलेक्शन होगा यार? Okay, now we'll go to the, dekho, what is the direction of this force? Anyone, what is the direction of this force? So this fluid, dekho, ye jo, see, how is this fluid exerting? And we have calculated vertical. So how is this fluid exerting? Downward. So this will be downward. Ye bhi downward hai, Dono downward hai. Now the problem is, all of you listen. Now the problem is the vertical component on BD. Look at carefully. Dekho, free surface kahan pe hai? Acha, okay. Free surface kahan pe hai? it is here. तो यहां से what is this length? ये 0.5 मीटर है. This is 0.5. चलो let's try to calculate now. देखो एक बार, देखो एक सेकंड सुनो ना, दिस इज द फ्री सरफेस. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट बीडी
के ऊपर क्या है? बीडी के ऊपर देर इज अ फ्लूइड ऑफ डेंसिटी 700 एंड दैट डेफिनेटली this fluid is influencing because of this, because iske karan the pressure is varying here. Because of this fluid the pressure, don't think that the pressure here is only due to this 800 fluid. No, yahan pe, so because of this depth of the fluid their pressure is influencing this column. This fluid is definitely influencing this.
Be careful. So therefore what is the density here? It is 800. अब देखो how, and this is the free surface. How do I calculate the vertical component of, इधर देखो, how do I calculate the vertical component of force? देखो एक बार, please listen. How do I calculate vertical component of force? कुछ मत करना, curve. I said curve. Your teacher has given beautiful points during derivation. ये curve ले लेना. कहाँ तक जाना है? ये curve लेके कहाँ तक जाना है? Free surface. Curve ले लो. Free surface. ये कर्व ले लो फ्री सरफेस एंड इस कर्व के ऊपर का वेट कैलकुलेट करना. ध्यान से सुनो, यू कैलकुलेट कर्व अबव. ये कर्व है, ये देखो ऐसा लग रहा है सी वर्टिकल कर्व. सो ये कर्व से कहां जाना है? फ्री सरफेस. सो कैलकुलेट द वेट ऑफ दिस. तो नाउ यू शुड, सो इस कर्व के ऊपर का वेट कैलकुलेट करना. ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. बट प्लीज ऑब्जर्व, हियर यू हैव टू टेक दिस फ्लूइड बिकॉज, लिसन माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर यू हैव टू टेक दिस फ्लूइड. देखो डोंट बी इन हरी बिकॉज दैट डेंसिटी इज डिफरेंट. This is 700 fluid. Now, this is, dekho, now this is our, Prashant ne class mein aa raha hai, class dal ki bolto. Okay, right. Now, please understand clearly, we have to calculate the vertical component. So, curve up to the free surface. Excellent, my dear students. And the diameter is given as 1 meter. And this is already known radius. This is 0.5. And this is also 0.5. Koi problem nahi hai. So vertical component is equal to weight. Which weight are we supposed to calculate? Curve up to the free surface. Okay, so why are you taking different densities? Ye alag hai, ye alag hai. So here the density of this is 700 and the density of this is 800. So, and you know on the bottom, dekho ek bar, please observe. Are? At the bottom on this, what is the direction of vertical component of force? Upwards. There are, this is downward, weight is downward. Total two downward should be equal to total upward. Okay. Now, let's calculate the weight of this. 1 second. Vertical component is equal to weight. Okay. So, iska weight calculate. First, we'll calculate volume of this. Volume. Iska volume kya hoga? Anyone, what is the volume? Dekho, area. What is the area? It is, huh? What is the volume? इट इज, चलो इसका वॉल्यूम इट इज पाई आर, रेडियस इज 0.5, पाई आर स्क्वायर, इट इज द एरिया ऑफ अ सर्कल बट इट इज सेमी सर्कल, it is semicircle, semicircle and but there is width also, what is the width into 2, ye volume aa gaya, ye volume aa gaya, but I want weight, what is weight, I repeat, iska volume, the volume of this is, it is semicircle, pi r radius is 0.5, pi r square by 2 is area and the perpendicular plane of the screen width is there too, to ye volume aa gaya, but how do I calculate weight of this, weight, rho of the fluid g into volume, this fluid is 800, this is 800, so 800 g is 9.81 into pi by 2 into 0.5 square into 2, ye weight aa gaya. Now let us try to calculate this weight, this weight, how do I calculate this weight, my dear students, rho of the fluid, it is 700, weight likh raha hu 700, rho g is 9.81 into rho g volume, rho g volume, rho g volume, what is the volume of this, area, 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 what is the area, 1 into 0.5 is the area, perpendicular plane of screen there is a width into 2 and total weight will be equal to, total weight is equal to this plus this, 700 into 9.81 into 1 into 0.5 into 2 plus this 800 into 9.81 into pi by 2 into 0.5 square into 2. So let us calculate the total weight and this will be in the upward direction. Why upward direction? Because we have calculated the vertical component on BD. So on BD the fluid is exerting in upward direction. On AB, the fluid is exerting downward. So downward on AB plus weight, total downward should be equal to this upward. Can you give me the value of this total force? Anyone? Total force, anyone? 13.03 kilonewton. Total weight is 28 newton. This is in the upward direction. So total upward is equal to total downward. What is total upward? 13028 is total upward, should be total downward. What is total downward? 736.8 plus weight of the cylinder. Weight of the cylinder. What is weight of the cylinder? Rho cylinder G pi by 4 d square into 2. Rho cylinder G is 9.81 and cylinder volume is pi by 4. D square, what is the diameter, 1 square into the width is 2, everything is known. Now I will calculate the value of density of cylinder, please give me the value, anyone, density of cylinder, ab ye bhi nahi denge to people will laugh at us, if you cannot give this value also people will laugh at us. I got 797. इतना कैलकुलेशन भी नहीं आ रहा देखो आपको. I got 797.6. Wonderful question. Bolo, bolo, wonderful question. Okay? Yes. Kg per meter cube, absolutely. Kya ho raha, Amit? Aap points, kya density calculate kar rahe hai, to aap kilo newton mein bol rahe hai. Amit, 0.797 किलो न्यूटन बोल रहा है आप, अरे वो तो डेंसिटी पूछा है आप किलो न्यूटन में दे रहे हैं, अब मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा क्या हो रहा है अमित, what is happening, my dear? Yes, absolutely. Sonupriya, great, great, absolutely. Yeah, you converted into another. Absolutely, great, great, absolutely. No problem at all, no problem at all, no problem at all. अरे क्या हो रहा है, आप यूनिट्स इतना गलत गलत क्यों दे रहे हैं? वेरी सैड, वेरी सैड, वेरी सैड ब्रो. व्हाट इज हैपनिंग ब्रो? हे ब्रो, हे ब्रो, टुडे योर हैंड इज फ्लक्चुएटिंग. व्हाई? डोंट बी इन हरी बेटा, डोंट बी इन हरी. सो वी आर डूइंग वंडरफुल क्वेश्चंस. So we are doing wonderful questions. Hai na? We'll take one more question, then we'll go to our regular objective questions. The question is this. Again, a good question. Koi baat nahi. Amit Baba. Baba Amit. बाबा अमित रे, बाबा अमित रे. यस, चलो चलो. अ ब्यूटिफुल क्वेश्चन. सी we'll take up one more good question. This is a wonderful question. This is a wonderful question. This is the autumn. We have to take care. Kitne baar bataya Mr. Surya Teja. Kitna beautiful explanation diya. The bottom portion, the pressure acting on the bottom portion is not just due to the fluid which it is exposed, it is also due to the top fluid. Now, just now I told you what will be the kitne acche point. The density is rho 1, density is rho 2. I want the pressure here. Though this point 2 is in the second fluid, do you think I should take rho g into this? Should I not take this? The weight of this fluid, the weight of this fluid is equal because of that. This weight and this weight, there is a pressure here. And how can I take only this? अरे कितना neatly बताया. Even though point 2 is exposed to second fluid, but the pressure at 2 is influenced not only by 2 but also of 1 na. But if the point is only here, then this is influenced only by this fluid. I told this very clearly and you are asking again and again. Neatly I explained. Surya Teja, is it clear? अरे कितना neatly explained किया and you are asking again. Chalo, now the question is, what a beautiful question this is. The question is, you are asking about CD. Which CD? CD. Hare yaar. On this port, what is the definition you have seen? Curve taken up to free surface. For portion, now tell me, for this portion, अरे यार फॉर दिस पोर्शन वेरी डू यू थिंक फॉर दिस पोर्शन द फ्री सरफेस इज हियर नो फॉर दिस ऑल्सो द फ्री सरफेस इज हियर ना फॉर दिस ऑल्सो द फ्री सरफेस इज हियर ना सो I never took the force on this. I never took the force on this. I took only on BC. I took only on BC. I have never touched this portion. This portion. So here the pressure is due to this column. So for this, where is the free surface? For this part, where is the free surface? This now. That's why I moved up to free surface. Okay, right. Now the question is a beautiful question is. There is a fluid here. Ab careful raho. Careful raho. Now be careful, my dear students. There is a fluid. This is all fluid. Yes. Now, what is he asking? Let's try to see. This height is 1 meter. Beautiful question. Now, this is automatic tipper. This is automatic tipper and there is hinge. So now the question is, what should be this height wherein it is about to tip? What do you mean by tip? Idhar dekhna. Please understand carefully. This is the tipper, let us say.
Bhai, kuch alag dusra color lo kya? Sab dikh raha hai na?
Yeah. As you, okay. Okay. Yeah. Assume this to be a tipper. Okay. It is hinged here. Now there is a ground surface. Echo. There is a ground surface here. So what should be this height of water so that it tips? This is tipping. So agar aap logics dekhenge, dekho ek baar. It is like this. My dear students, so thoda my see, the fluid is exerting force on this. This fluid is exerting force on this. It is a plane surface. It is inclined plane. Inclined plane. So, for plane surfaces, hydrostatic force will act at the center of pressure. Let us see two situations. Situation one, center of pressure acting somewhere here below. Okay, I'll take this as a kaam karte hai. A hinge ko O le lenge, hinge portion O, and let us say this as A O B. Okay, let us say case one. The hydrostatic force acting below this O means in this region AO may. Second case, hydrostatic force acting above O, OB may. Two cases. First case, hydrostatic force acting in AO, matlab is region mein act kar raha hai. Arey yaar, jab height badhte jayega, to ye point kahan shift hoga, upar shift hoga. So now let us. He is asking what should be this height so that it tips. The logic is very simple. Idhar dekhna. This is the ground. I'm sure this one. Dekho ek baar, please. This one. I'm showing by this hand. This is the tipper. Now, this is the hinge. This is the tipper. Update now. If the force is acting below this, dekho. This is supporting. Dekho. This is supporting. It will not tip. If the force is acting above, it is tipping off. Means it will tip off. It will tip off. When the center of pressure, the hydrostatic force is acting above this point. Is hinge se upar hoga, agar dekho, agar ye force रुको
this will tip off.
So if it is acting above this, it will tip off. But if it is acting below this, देखो, below this, it is not tipping up. If the hydrostatic force is acting below this, it is not tipping up. देखो, support कर रहा है, ये support कर रहा है. अगर ये वही देखो, क्या? अगर इसके ऊपर है, तो it will tip off. तो हम क्या करेंगे? तो limiting condition क्या होगा? अगर center of pressure, see the limiting condition is if the center of pressure is here, it is about to tip. So if the center of pressure is here, it is about. इससे नीचे it will not tip off. इससे ऊपर above. So when H is will calculate the center of pressure. So इससे ऊपर होगा तो वो tip off होगा. I repeat my dear friends. So it's like this. फिर से बताओ सुनो. वो पूछ रहा है what should be height H? What should be this height H so that it will tip off? Means देखो एक बार ऐसा है, if the center of pressure is below this देखो ये support है, see it's not tipping off. If it is above देखो tip हो गया. So for limiting case here is the center of pressure. So now tell me where is the center of pressure? So this is the center of pressure. Limiting case this is the center of pressure. Means अगर hydrostatic force यहाँ act कर रहा है about to tip. इससे नीचे नो टिपिंग, इससे ऊपर टिपिंग. सो ही इज आस्किंग दैट लिमिटिंग पॉइंट. प्लीज टेल मी इज द क्वेश्चन क्लियर? राइट. Okay, na? Is it okay? Awesome. So here lies our center of pressure. Can you tell me the distance of center of pressure? All are measured from the free surface. Okay. So here, here we have center of pressure. So where is the center of pressure? The total height is h. This is 1 meter. Can I write this height as? इधर देखना. The total height is h. This is 1. H minus 1. So xCP is h minus 1. Let this be 0.1. Now, don't worry. So, okay. XCP is, we have calculated. So, XCP is equal to, let this be equation number 1. Okay. Ab dekho. Dekho, my dear students. Now, what is this angle? If this is 60, same line horizontal, so this will be 60 degree. Okay, means our theta is 60 degree. Long back I have given, I don't know whether you remember or not. XCP is equal to x bar plus IG by AX bar sine square theta, where XCP is the vertical distance of center of pressure measured from the free surface. I gave this very clearly. Okay. Now, please understand carefully. Let us take this. This one, AB. A. B. AB. And this vertical height is given. 1 second, please. This is H. okay now
this angle is theta.
My question to you people is, can I calculate the length of AB? Can I calculate the length of AB? Easily I can calculate. Easily I can calculate. Okay. Are yaar, ye bhi nahi aa raha. Dekho. This is A, this is B, this is 60. The vertical height. This vertical height is H. So AB will be how much? Anyone? Sine theta is opposite by AB. So AB will be equal to sine theta is H by AB. AB is H by sine theta. H by sine theta. No problem at all. Whenever the width is not given, I will take it as 1. Whenever the width is not given, I will take it as 1. And this length is H by sine 60. Just now you have calculated. This length AB is H by sine 60. Iska width nahi diya. So I will take this width as 1 meter. No problem at all. Now, let this be the center of gravity. Of course, this is the free surface. Can you tell me the meaning of X bar? Yes, this is X bar. So, where will be the center of gravity? Anyone? Where will be? Agar ye H hai, toh where will be the center of gravity? H by 2. H by 2. Where will be the center of gravity? Ariyar, if the vertical height is H, if this vertical height is H, the total height is H, where will be the center of gravity? It will be H by 2. So X bar is H by 2. Now, moment of inertia. I have already told you long back. This is G. G. What is the moment of inertia? What is the moment of inertia? What is the moment of inertia about this axis? It will be B D cube. It will be B D cube by 12. So I told very clearly. Let's calculate IG. What is IG? About this axis, ek bar notes dekhna. About this axis, already I explained very clearly, parallel to OO dash, notes dekhna. So about this axis, what will be moment of inertia? B, 1 into this cube. So moment of inertia will be B, this is B, this is B, and this is D. D is H by sine 60. So B, D cube, H by sine 60. B D cube by 12. Very good. Now let us substitute in this equation. I am calculating XCP. So XCP is equal to X bar. Already X bar is known, H by 2 plus IG. It will be H cube by sine cube 60 by 12. BD cube by 12, IG by area. What is the area? See the area of this. Width is 1, it is H by sine 60. Area, 1 into H by sine 60. Okay, A, X bar. Dekho, I am substituting all values in this. X bar, H by 2. IG, please, IG, BD cube by 12. IG, BD cube by 12. By area, this is the area, H into X bar, again divided with area, X bar. So what is X bar? X bar, H by 2 into sine square 60. Very good, my dear students. Into sine square 60. Excellent, my dear students. So this sine 60 will go to the top. When it goes to the top, sine square 60 into sine 60 kitna hoga? This sine 60 will go to the top. Sine square 60 into sine 60 is sine cube. This sine cube gets cancelled. So I am removing all sine squares. So we have XCP is equal to H by 2 plus, dekho ek bar, this 2 will go to the top, 2 H cube दिस टू विल गो टू द टॉप, ये टू ऊपर जाएगा, एच क्यूब देर इज एच क्यूब बाय 12 एच स्क्वायर, देयरफॉर एक्स सी पी इज इक्वल टू एच बाय 2 प्लस एच बाय 6 एंड दैट इज इक्वल टू 3 से मल्टीप्लाई करना, 3 प्लस 1 4 है ना, देखो 3 से मल्टीप्लाई करना तो 3 प्लस 1 4 4 बाय 6 इज 2 एच बाय 3. So already I know XCP from first equation. What is XCP? Already I know this is the first equation. Please look at my dear students. Equation 1, equation 2. So therefore XCP is H minus 1 and XCP is 2H by 3. Let us equate. So what do I get? So H minus 2H by 3 is equal to 1. H minus 2H by 3. Or h by 3. So 3h minus 2 is h by 3. So h by 3 is 1. So h is equal to 3 meter. H is equal to 3 meter. Iska matlab, what is the physical meaning of this? Physical meaning of this. If h is 3 meter, center of pressure will be here about it. If h is more than this, more than this, center of pressure will shift above and it will tip. If H is less than this, it will not tip. Is it clear? It's a beautiful question, my dear friends. All of you, have you followed? What a beautiful question. If H is above that, it will start tipping. So this height, if it is more than this 3 meter, already we got h as 3. If this is more than 3 meter, CP will be above, it will tip off. If h is less than 3, CP will be below, it will not tip. It's a beautiful question. So the answer of h is 3. See, we have done some wonderful questions today. Seriously, awesome. Okay, now, so we'll take up our regular questions. Kal kahan tak kiye the? Okay. We'll take up one by one in detail. Yeah. This is also one of the good questions. Read the question. It is a combination of. Yeah. Yes, exactly, Amit. Exactly. Read the question. In this question, if length AB, yes, exactly. You can check. Yes, definitely. Come on, my dear students. Come on, read the question. Next question is a beautiful question. हो गया पढ़ना. चलो वेल प्रोसीड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आगे बढ़े. This is also a good question. See, the figure below shows a gate PQR. The weight of the gate is negligible. The gate opens when? Again, a good question. It's like this. The question is like this. Ye gate hai. Dekho, this is the gate. This is the gate.
I'll explain clearly. Dekho. This is a game. Actually, in your figure, the width is not given. Dekho, please. P, Q, R. Okay, na? Chalo. This is all fluid. At the bottom, there is a fluid. This side, there is a fluid. So, it is a plane vertical surface. It is a plane horizontal surface. So, it is a combination of both vertical and horizontal surfaces. Okay, dekho ek baar. Now, this fluid will exert a force like this. So, it will turn like this. And this fluid will exert a force like this. So, the moment of this force is in this direction. This about this hinge. It is tilting about hinge. Aisa ho raha hai. Dekho, aisa. Okay. So, if the moment of this force is like this and the moment of this force is like this. So, when both balance, it is in equilibrium. And if this moment is more, it will open. So, he is asking what should be the value of this height so that it opens up. Excellent, Sonu Priyaji. Great. So very simple. So what we do is, I'll do something like this. Very good. I'm very happy that some of you are doing beautifully. Wait. Please do not take the portion where there is no water. Force will act only where there is a fluid. Perfect. Dekho, please let me do it very neatly. Let this be P, Q, R. Very good. Now, so this is, see, don't take this portion where there is no fluid, or take only that portion where there is a fluid. Now, let's do it. It is a combination of both horizontal and vertical. Let us try to calculate the hydrostatic force on PQ. It is a plane surface. The hydrostatic force is given by WAX bar. This width is not given. I will take it as 1 meter. The width is not given, so we'll take it as 1 meter. Okay. Now, the width is given as 1 meter, no problem at all. And this is given, this length is given. And this height is given as h. Okay, now the force on PQ is equal to W, okay, area. So, can you tell me the area of PQ? Dekho PQ, this area. I'm talking about this area. Yeah. So what is the area of PQ? PQ, PQ area. This is H and this is 1. ये H चलिए बन है, so therefore it is H into 1. Can you give me the value of X bar? What is the meaning of X bar? It is the vertical distance of center of gravity measured from the face surface. So therefore, so can I write X bar as H by 2? If this total height is H, so from the field surface, if this is H, center of gravity will be H by 2. Yes, I can write. So the hydrostatic force on PQ is WH square by 2. But where does this force act? Always remember, the hydrostatic force will always act at the center of pressure, not center of gravity. And we have derived one beautiful equation in previous classes. Whenever the top edge is coinciding with the free surface, whenever the top edge is coinciding with the free surface for a rectangle, the center of pressure will be 2/3 of height from the free surface. Agar ye height h hai, if this is h, it will act 2/3 from the top or 1/3 from the bottom. 2/3 from the top. So this will be our center of pressure. Where does it act? 2/3 from the top or 1/3 from the bottom? Very good. Now, let's take this surface. Ye wala. We'll take this. Try to find out the force on this. Hold on, don't be in a hurry. Let's try to find out the force on this. Yes. And please tell me, where is the free surface? Dekho, where is the free surface? This is the free surface. Can you tell me what is this height h? So center of gravity will be somewhere here, and you know clearly this height. देखो ये height कितना है, ये vertical height कितना है, h. So h, this is the free surface, because this is the free surface. देखो एक बार, this is the free surface. Can you tell me what is the pressure here? It is because of this fluid. It is because of, देखो एक बार, फिर से बताओ. So whatever the pressure is acting on this surface, bottom one, ye bottom wale pe. So jo bhi pressure is bottom pe aa raha hai, because of this complete height of the fluid, this is the free surface, this is the free surface. So whatever the pressure is acting on this, it is because of this complete height of the fluid. That's why for this, the free surface is this. So what is the force? WX bar, W area. What is the area? This is B and this is width is 1. Ye X bar, what is X bar? Free surface, height H. So therefore, now this will be the dekho ek baar, force on QR. And where does it act? CG. Agar width b hai to where will be CG? If the width is b, where will be the CG? b by 2. This is b by 2. Now let us calculate the force on QR. Can you tell me what is, again it is a plane horizontal surface. So it is a plane horizontal surface. What is the area? The total width is B, this is B and this is 1. So therefore, W area, B into 1 into X bar. What is X bar? Dekho, for this X bar is, dekho, please observe, don't get confused. So for this horizontal, this is the center of gravity. This is the center of gravity. Dekho, this is horizontal, this is... This is the center of gravity. G, this is the center of gravity. So where is X bar? Free surface is this free surface. So G free, vertical distance from the free surface. So this is h, this is h. X bar, this is the center of gravity. X bar is h. So therefore it is h. So this will be WBH. Correct? WBH. Now let us take moments. It is tilting about this. It is tilting about this. So take moment about this, moment about this. FPQ into H by 3 is clockwise. FQR into B by 2 is anticlockwise. For equilibrium, both moments must be same. Take moment about Q. So as it is a hinge, so moment must be zero at the hinge because there is no restraint. Freely it can rotate. There is no constraint for the moment at the hinge. It can easily tilt. So therefore, resisting moment is zero, means net moment should be zero. So FPQ into H by 3, FPQ into H by 3 clockwise should be equal to FQR into B by 2, into B by 2, and this is clockwise, this is anti-clockwise, into B by 2. So therefore, what is FPQ? WH square by 2 into H by 3, FQR, WBH into B by 2. So this is gone, W is gone, now H is gone. So therefore, H square by 3 is equal to, H square by 3 is equal to B square. So therefore, H square is 3B square, or H is equal to under root of 3B. This is the answer. This is a beautiful question because it shows the combination of horizontal and vertical. Are Baba, are we clear? All of you. Excellent. Move to the next. Take this question. Read the question. Please read the next question. Please read the next question. Read the next question. Let's take up this a simple question. A vertical gate 6 meter by 6 meter. 6 meter, 6 meter. Holds water on one side with free surface at top. Yes, with free surface at top. This is the bottom edge. Okay. This is the bottom edge. What is he asking in the problem? He is asking, what is the moment of, dekho, he is asking, what is the moment about the bottom edge of the hydrostatic force? Now tell me, this is the vertical surface. It is a vertical surface. So plane vertical surface, where is the hydrostatic force acting? It will act at the center of pressure. Always remember, the hydrostatic force acts at the center of pressure. This is the plane surface and he is asking the force on this. Okay, no problem at all. Then how do I calculate? Hydrostatic force is given by W A X bar. Okay, F is W. Can you give me the area of this? This is 6 meter. This is also 6 meter. So what is the area of this? 6 into 6, x bar. So where is the center of gravity? Somewhere here. And this is our x bar. So if the total height is 6 meter, half of this will be 3 meter. So therefore into 3. So this force is given by kitna aa raha hai 36108 W. But what is he asking, my dear students? He is asking the moment of hydrostatic force about the bottom edge. Tell me, whenever the top edge is coinciding with the free surface, the center of gravity, center of pressure will be below the center of gravity, and you know very well, 2/3 of this from the free surface, 2/3 of 6 is 4. From the top, it will be 4 meter. The force will act from here. But he is asking the moment about the bottom. The total height is 6, this is 4. So this will be 2. So what will be the moment about the bottom edge? Moment here will be F into this length is 2 meter. And therefore it is 108W. Already F is known, 108W into 2. And that is 216W. So, but W in the problem, he is taking specific weight as gamma. Yeah. It is 108 into 2, that is 216 is the right answer. Please tell me, are we clear? Chalo. And today I am going to give you assignment. And you have to do it. There is no other way. In this problem, data is missing. But logically you can solve this problem. I repeat my decision. In this problem, dimensions are not given. But use your common sense and give the answer. Waiting for your answers. Use your common sense and give the answer. I'm checking. Container having square cross section is filled. See, I'm regularly checking in mobile whether the live streaming is going perfectly or not. So it's going perfectly, no problem at all. There is a, in mobile there is a small lag of about 8 seconds, but laptop mein thoda zyada hai. So I'm regularly checking. Don't think that I'm checking mobile in class. My class ko check kar raha hu. Now. Container having cross section filled, having square cross section is filled up to a height of 6. Okay, this is the container. This is a cutter. Dekho, square cross section, and the height is 0.6 meter. Okay, a container having square cross section is filled, and height is a. Kya bola? It is filled up to a height. Height can be anything. Height can be anything, but it is filled with water up to a height of 0.6 meter. Up to a height of 0.6 meter. Okay. Can anyone? Very good Aditya Sharma. Okay. What is the net force? Pucha hai. Net force ke liye unit dimension. Location of center of pressure from the bottom. Can anyone tell where will be the center of pressure? So if the free, this is the free surface, from free surface it will be 2/3 of 0.6, that is 0.4. From the top it will be 0.4. But he is not asking from the top. From the top, he is asking from the bottom. From the bottom. Dekho, from the bottom. So if it is 0.6, 0.4, this will be 0.2. From the bottom, it will be 0.2. So there is only one option with 0.2. That is common sense. So whenever you find two questions, in a single question, if we have two parts, be careful. Sometimes there is no need for you to do the second part. If you get one part correctly and no other options are matching with that, directly you can take the answer and go. And some students, what they do, they calculate both. You should calculate. If there is one more option of 0.2, then you need to calculate the force. But in this problem, there is only one option with 0.2. So obviously this will be the answer. So you don't have to calculate the this part. It is nothing but examiner, in these type of questions, he will try to eliminate. So please, please, my dear students, certain things are very, very important. They will definitely trouble you with this. Okay, chalo. Aage badhte hain. Take this question. And again a good question. Again a very good question. Come on, my dear students. Yeah, this is also a good question. A rectangular tank with length, width, dekho, length, width. Length is 2, width is 1, and height. Again, it is 2. Is completely filled with water. This is our free surface. It is completely filled with water. This height is 2. This height is 2. Okay. Kya pucha hai? The ratio of height. Okay. The ratio of height. This is 1. This is 2. The ratio of hydrostatic force at the bottom. So this is the bottom. And if you see, my dear students, what is, where is the free surface? If this is the bottom, ye wala 2 hai, ye wala 1 hai, and this height is, dekho, ye vertical height, how much is this vertical height? Ye kitna hai? 2 meter. Can you tell me, what is the hydrostatic force on the horizontal surface? A horizontal surface, W, area. What is the area of this bottom? 2 into 1. W, A, X bar. So this is the center of gravity. This is the center of gravity. So where will be X bar? From the free surface. Dekho, ye free hai. Ye free surface. So this height is 2 meter. W, A, X bar, 2 meter. So therefore, the horizontal, the force on the bottom. So I write this as bottom. This is bottom. This is the bottom surface. Is equal to 4W. So hydrostatic force at the bottom to that on any larger vertical surface.
You have to catch the word larger vertical surface.
There are four vertical surfaces. Front, back, right, left. Let us say areas of this. This is 2 meter or 2 units, whatever it may be. This is 2 and this is 1. So what is the area of this? It is 2 into 1, that is 2. Let's calculate the area of front one. Front one. So this is 2 meter. This is 2 meter. So what is the area of this front? This is also vertical. This is also vertical. So the area will be 4. Obviously, the larger one is front or back. So let's try to calculate the force on the larger one. Let's try to calculate the force on the larger one. This is the larger vertical surface. अब देखते हैं. And if you want the force on large LV का मतलब आ जाए, it is plane surface, so hydrostatic force is W is what? W. Can you tell me the area? This is 2, this is 2, this is 2, this is 2. Area is 2 into 2, WA, X bar. What is X bar? देखना. This is G and this is the free surface. So the total height is 2 meter. So this will be X bar and this is 1. So it is 1. So the large on force on the larger vertical surface is 4W. So therefore, he is asking ratio of force at the bottom to that on any larger vertical surface. So at the bottom, it is 4W. And the larger vertical surface is also 4W, that is 1. That is 1. So the answer is 1. It's a beautiful question, my dear students.